a download from Triple J.
For more music, current affairs, comedy and culture, triplej.net.au.
And now...
Triple J.
Triple J.
Triple J.
Triple J Mornings with Zan.
Lots of people have been raving about the album. Lots of people have included your album in their sort of top 10 lists for 98. It's your fourth solo album. Anything about this one which makes it more special to you than your other releases so far?
Just that it's not as old as the other ones yet. Yeah, but at this point, it's pretty old to me, too. I mean, I'm working on the next one, but I don't know. I don't really think about it much, you know? It's kind of done.
First the mic, then a half cigarette.
Are you even more confused these days as to where you fit into the whole music scene, given the fact that you had a huge exposure last year with the Academy Awards?
Definitely. Yeah, it's really weird. But the less I think about it, the happier I am.
Yeah.
You know, because I don't really care where I fit into anything or if there's anything to fit into. It's just, I like music, you know? That's the thing. It's very uncomplicated.
Gonna love you anyhow.
Do you regret appearing on the Academy Awards?
No, it's just, you know. No. I mean, it was a curious situation. It was really weird. And it was kind of a kick in its way. Wouldn't want to do it again. And I didn't enjoy being like the Oscar guy or having like to talk about that over and over and over. But
it would have given you an insight into a world or a part of the entertainment world that very few performers who are in your field would have gotten.
Well, it was totally bizarre that someone like me was on that show. I knew that.
It was quite surreal watching it. It must have been even more surreal actually being you.
It was very strange because it wasn't difficult. I didn't feel nervous, but it was just like a slow motion, you know? And the people I expected to be really kind of weird and self-important weren't, you know? So it was kind of strange.
What, people like Celine Dion, who actually came up to you?
Yeah, like, she was, really personable and really sweet, you know? Her music, that's not my thing, but she's really nice, you know?
Yeah, what she said to you, she said, are you nervous?
Yeah. And I wasn't, but I said I was so she could say what she was gonna say, you know?
Yeah.
I might have been a little bit, but... And she was like, well, it's good to be nervous, you know, it'll help you sing better. Get some adrenaline going. I'll be nervous too. But don't worry, because it's a beautiful song, and I'm going to be listening, and everyone's going to be listening, and all this.
So, including yourself, there's three people on stage now.
Right, yeah.
And that's the way it's going to continue for a while longer?
At least a week.
At least a week, and then it's just a big question mark.
Yeah, I don't know. I mean, it'll continue longer than that. I mean, I like playing acoustic too, but I did that for a long time, and now it's fun to do this. Also, if you play acoustic, no matter what you do, you're just going to be seen as a folk singer. It gets kind of annoying.
What's so wrong? I mean, a lot of people say that. A lot of singer-songwriters hate that tag, the folk singer tag. What's so wrong with it?
Well, it kind of picks you up from wherever you are and drops you off in this little ghetto of rampant sentimentality, you know, that's associated with, like, certain kinds of singer-songwriters. It's like, I don't live here, I don't want to be here, you know? I'm not coming from that Simon and Garfunkel place. I'm coming more from, like, Shane McGowan kind of place, for example, or like a certain, like, energy that's in punk or pop.
Yeah, but that doesn't sort of come out. You used the word sentimentality before, but, you know, that sort of Shane McGowan, he can be quite sentimental within the lyrics that he writes as well.
Yeah, but it's different. Or it is to me. There's a type of, like, singer-songwriter, you know, that whole thing is sort of like, it's just, it bothers some people because it's just too crafty. And they're not trying to be crafty, they're just trying to be real, you know? So it's like they don't really want to make up this super polished song that where everything is in its place and it all sounds very sweet and contrived. They want to, like, make up a song that's more, it's like a pop that's more coming from, like, a kind of punk place, if that makes any sense.
Misery, like you say.